Okay, so we finally arrived at what I gathered as sort of tips for how to do sampling. So the most important thing I would say is really think of the sampling. You know, like what is it that you want to find out, and how can you get enough diversity but not too much? That's another thing to really be aware of. In your sample, right? One, you know, quick solution, and this is something that we also use predefined samples. So here I put active 10. This is actually one project. I will link it. I just see that I haven't included the link here, and they have more languages. But this is a relatively small sample that was also designed to represent, you know, the totality of languages, even if this is very small. Then, you know, you have WOLS 100, you have WOLS 200, so why not use languages from those samples? So that would be my tip. Then, you know, think a bit more about randomness, right? Whenever you can, try to be random. So that's really something that saves some unnecessary trouble, let's say like that. Because, you know, often we think, okay, so I will just mix a bit my sample. But this mix a bit my sample, it's usually biased. So, and usually it's actually very easy to be random, yeah? So, or close to random. So that's one small change that we could do in order to get a better generalization. Yeah, finally think within language diversity. So this is really something that, you know, I'm just saying it, but I see that it's coming, and I'm very, very happy to follow these developments. And finally, prefer good estimates over good performance. So this is something that I think in NLP, and I also blame myself for this because I know how easy it is to fall in this. The results in this setting, you look much better. In this setting, not so good. And so I cannot blame people for, you know, preferring this setting, but I think we should actually go for something like this. Okay, so that's pretty much what I intended to say. So here are just two references that are not available quickly, easily online. So this is why I say in case you have access, right? But the rest, you can normally just go on my file, and then you can click and find the references directly there to read if you're interested to dig a little bit deeper into these questions.